Hello, and welcome to the Azure Logging and Monitoring session for ISVs. I'm Hala Manasi, and I'm going to be your presenter for this session. I'm a service engineer in Fast Track for Azure, and I'm very excited to be talking to you all today about what the Azure platform has to offer for monitoring your solution. This is part one of three for our session today. In this part of the session, we will focus on Azure Monitor, what it is, overview of the landscape, and some terminology you would need to know to better understand how logging and monitoring is set up on Azure. We will also take a deeper look at the sources where the data is captured and what can be monitored on Azure. And for the final part of this session, we will also take a look at some continuous monitoring options you have for your solution. In later parts, we will go over platform metrics, infrastructure metrics, and how to set up alerts and much more. You can find all the reference links from this session at aka.ms/loggingreference, which will include all the documentation and learning links that I present in this session. Now let's get started. Azure Monitor is a service in Azure that provides performance and availability monitoring for applications and services in Azure, other cloud environments, or even on-premises. Azure Monitor collects data from multiple sources into a common data platform where it can be analyzed for trends and anomalies. This diagram gives a high-level view of Azure Monitor. At the center of the diagram, we have metrics and logs, which are the two fundamental types of data stores used by Azure Monitor. On the left are the sources of monitoring data that populate these data stores, which we will be going over shortly. We will get into the right-hand side of this diagram later on in the session. Now let's take a moment to go over those two fundamental types of data used by Azure Monitor, metrics and logs. Metrics are numerical values that describe some aspect of a system at a particular point in time. They are lightweight and capable of supporting near real-time scenarios. Logs, on the other hand, contain different kinds of data organized into records with different sets of properties for each type. Telemetry such as events and traces are stored as logs in addition to performance data so that it can be combined for analysis. Keep that in mind as we go over the Azure Monitoring platform in greater detail. Now, Azure Monitor can collect data from a variety of sources. You can think of monitoring data for your solutions in tiers ranging from your application, the infrastructure, which includes the operating system and services it relies on, down to the Azure platform itself. But it all starts with collecting telemetry. Depending on the type of resource, Azure Monitor will provide a corresponding way to collect telemetry. One source are custom logs. Azure Monitor can collect log data from any REST client using the Data Collector API. This allows you to create custom monitoring scenarios and extend monitoring to resources that don't expose telemetry through other sources ordinarily. For example, there may be a SAP workload that you want to inject some business telemetry into. This can be done with our injection APIs. Now, custom logs can be a presentation on its own, so we will keep it brief for today. For a deeper look, I have included more on custom logs in the references section. Next, we look at the network level. The data that Azure Monitor collects starts with the Azure platform itself. This includes Azure resources, subscriptions, and tenants. So things like sign-on information from Active Directory audit logs, the activity logs for service health, configuration changes for your Azure resources, and much more. It also includes resource logs, which provide performance details of each resource within Azure. Then we have the infrastructure level. These are compute resources, such as virtual machines or containers, supporting your application's infrastructure. This requires an agent to collect logs and performance data from the guest operating system's workloads. These VMs can live in Azure, another cloud, or on-premises. You can also connect to an existing system's Center of Operations Manager environment. A common scenario for ISVs, however, is utilizing microservices like containers for their infrastructure. But monitoring for containers is a lot more complex than a standard VM. Containers come and go so frequently. The environment is shared, which can cause noisy neighbor issues. There are no tools within the container, so there's no central view for logs and performance. So the solution we have for this is Azure Monitor for containers. This allows us to analyze Kubernetes and container deployment for performance, events, health, and logs. Since this is a common scenario among our ISVs, I will go over what that looks like in Azure and how to set that up later on in the session. Finally, we look at the application itself. For the application, we use the Application Insights feature of Azure Monitor, no surprise, to gather detailed metrics and logs. These metrics and logs can be related to the performance and operation of an application written in any language in any environment. For an even more in-depth look at all the data sources used to collect data in Azure Monitor, look at our documentation, which will be linked in our resources. This gives a greater look on what sources the logs and metrics are coming from. Now that we know the types of data being collected, what exactly can be monitored in Azure? The following table lists Azure services and the data they collect into Azure Monitor. Pretty much any resource within Azure can be monitored. Take the time to go through the Azure docs to make sure your resource is covered and understand what insights you can leverage. So we briefly covered the types of ways you can gain insight on the performance of your solution. The Azure Monitor platform, however, also has the ability to support continuous monitoring. Continuous monitoring refers to the process and technology required to incorporate monitoring across each phase of your DevOps and IT operations lifecycles. Azure Monitor works seamlessly with Visual Studio and Visual Studio Code during development and test. It also integrates with Azure DevOps for release management and work item management during the deployment and operations. It even integrates across the ITSM and SIEM tools of your choice to help track issues and incidents within your existing IT processes. Now, enough talking about the Azure Monitor platform. Let's head over to the Azure Portal to see what it looks like in action. To follow along at home, click on the top left menu button. You will see there is a monitor blade. In here is where you will see the control center for all the monitoring done on Azure. So on the left-hand menu, you will see four sections: Overview, Insights, Settings, and Support and Troubleshooting. For the remainder of this part of the presentation, we will mainly be focusing on the Overview section of the menu. In the following session, we will take a moment to look at the Insights section, mainly the Containers tab. It is important to note that coming to Monitor Blade is not the only way to access Azure Monitor. Within each resource in the Azure portal, there will always be a monitoring section where you can see alerts, metrics, and logs. We won't have time to go over every part of this menu, but I encourage you to spend some time in the portal to familiarize yourself with all the things you see here. Now let's begin with the metrics section. So if you go to the metrics button, you will see that you will be asked to select a scope for monitoring. Since you can have multiple subscriptions in one tenant, the Azure subscription you wish to leverage insight from is that scope. Then you will be asked to select the resource type you want to look into, as well as the location and what the actual resource is. You can see all kinds of insights here by selecting what you want to view from the dropdown. If you want to perform an aggregation of the data, simply select it from the aggregation dropdown. Once you are satisfied with the view, you will be able to save it and even share it via Excel. You can also pin it to the dashboard if it's something you need to see often. There's also the option to share it with colleagues via a sharing link if they have access to your subscription. As an aside, for Azure Governance and Subscription Management, we have other pre-recorded content done by my colleague you can take a look at, which is also linked in the resources. One thing to note is that by default, these metrics are only stored for up to 30 days. If you need to save these metrics longer than that, you will need to push them to another storage location, like Azure Blob Storage or Daylake. follow the instructions and the resources provided for a step-by-step on how to accomplish that. Now we move along to our activity log. In your activity log, you can see recent activities like resources being made or deleted, successful or failed deployments, and what operations occurred, as well as who initiated them, and so on. This is just one example of the types of data collected that was mentioned earlier, but you can see that there are a lot of activities within the activity log, and you can filter by what is relevant to you. This was a quick overview of what you can see in the portal for Azure Monitoring. We will explore other parts of Azure Monitor in the next video. So to recap, Azure Monitor typically collects and groups telemetry at the application, platform, or infrastructure level. The application level is the user and application telemetry and logs. The platform level is data collected by Azure itself, like the resources, subscriptions, and tenants. And the infrastructure level is data collected via an agent added onto your compute resources, like a VM. This concludes part 1 of 3 for this session. In the next part of the series, we'll go over what you need to do to actually leverage those insights at each tier of your solution. I hope this session has inspired you to see what you can do to monitor your solution in Azure. See you in the next one!